More graphic pictures and testimony as prosecutors continue to build their theory that former APD officer Levi Chavez killed his wife. It's day two of the trial in Sandoval County. That's where Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez joins us live with our continuing coverage.
Well, Doug, today the jury saw more pictures of Terrence Chavez's dead body in her bed. They also saw the spent bullet casing and a note that prosecutors say was written 1 week before Terrence's death. Day two of his trial, and Levi Chavez kept his head down for most of the time, pen in hand, but not writing. Tara Chavez's mom, Teresa Cordova, was one of few in the gallery. So was Chavez's father, sitting directly in back of him.
Are you starting to form an opinion that this is a suicide?
Yes, ma'am.
Jurors heard from the former deputy field medical investigator, who testified the scene appeared to be a suicide. They also saw pictures of Tara's body, including where Chavez's APD-issued gun was resting, the barrel facing her head on the inside of her right forearm. But what may turn out to be one of the key pieces of evidence was a ripped-up note hidden at the bottom of the bathroom garbage can.
And why did you tape it together?
In order for it to be read.
Lead prosecutor Brian McKay says the note was written 9 days before her death. It read, "I'm so sorry. All I wanted was your love. I'm sorry I wasn't good enough for you. I hope you'll be happy now. I always loved you, all of you, so much." Now, prosecutors also played the recorded statement from Levi Chavez that night. It's very emotional. It's tough to hear at times, and I'll have some clips for you coming up tonight at 6. Reporting live from Sandoval County, I'm Ana Velasquez, KOAT Action 7 News.
For extended coverage of this trial, go to KOAT.com. In our feature section, you'll find a timeline of the Tara Chavez murder case. It starts in October 2007 when she was found dead. And every day you can watch the trial unfold from inside the courtroom. When court is in session, we are live streaming it at KOAT.com. We'll also have a live blog you can follow, getting the latest updates from our reporters in the courtroom.